This simulation that we will be using today was developed by the PhET project and can be found at the link on the bottom of the screen. This activity is designed to be an introduction to equilibrium. There are other tabs that we can explore, but this video will focus on the Rate Experiments tab. There is a lot that was developed and embedded into this tab that is of value to investigate. For this screencast, we will focus our attention into first determining how to change the initial concentrations of the reactants and products. We will start our experiment with A at 20 particles, BC at 15, AB at 1, and C at 0. In this box, we also have the ability to change the initial temperature of the system. Changing the temperature changes the total average energy of the particles, which can be viewed in the diagram in the lower middle box. We will adjust the temperature to a point where we expect the reaction to happen, such as this. At this point, the average energy of the particles is high enough that at least some of the particles will have enough energy to react. Before we begin the experiment, we should set up a way where we can visualize and quantify the experiment. We will click on the strip chart option. This chart plots time on the x-axis and number of molecules is plotted on the y-axis. This will plot the number of molecules present at every second the experiment is running. Lastly, we will zoom out on the strip chart so we can see 20 molecules on the y-axis. As we get this reaction started, we will want to pay close attention to the amount of the reactants on the strip chart because they may start to change rapidly. Now we will begin the experiment. On the left-hand side of the screen, we have a simulation of several particles bumping and colliding into each other. As each of these particles collide into each other, you can observe the number of particles changing on the strip chart. You can see four different colored lines corresponding to each of the four particles. You are also able to see the box labeled current amounts on the right-hand side, which corresponds to the values on the strip chart. Do we have more reactants or products at the beginning of the simulation? Pause the screencast and answer part A of question 3. Let the reaction continue on for a while. Pay close attention to the strip chart and current amounts box. Pause the screencast and answer part B of question 3. Note that A is reacting with BC in the forward direction and C is reacting with AB in the reverse direction. Now we will hit end experiment. Let's restart the experiment and think more carefully about what's going on. When we restart the experiment, watch carefully and determine at the beginning which reaction is happening faster. Pause the screencast and answer 3C and D. Now, after the reaction has been going on for a while, what can you say about the relative rates of the forward and reverse reactions? Pause the screencast and answer parts E and F. Now we will pause the simulation and increase the concentration of C by 20 molecules. Before we restart the experiment, think about what will happen to each of the reactants and products when we restart the simulation. You should be able to explain your predictions using collision theory. Pause the screencast and record your predictions and explanations in 4A. Now we will press play to test your predictions. Pause the screencast and answer for B and C. Now, hopefully you are familiar with the simulations and you can go to the PhET website and finish out the rest of your assignment.